Most digital calipers have some kind of a serial interface for connecting them to a computer. But what's special about these two is they actually output the position in units of 1.25 microns, which is why I've got wire soldered onto them. Now, with these hooked up to my Raspberry Pi computer and reading all the readings that come out of it, we can see they jump around quite a bit, so they're not accurate to 1.25 microns.
But ideally, if I average enough readings together, I should be able to get a resolution of 1 micron.
But calipers are not normally accurate to the micron because they just have too much flex, so depending on how hard I squeeze here, I can easily get this to change by a couple of hundredths of a millimeter. So for more accurate readings, you really need something like a micrometer, which is a lot stiffer and has this clickety thing that allows me to apply a consistent force. But if I just use them as some sort of a linear position sensor, then that flex doesn't matter so much.
And to test this, I need to move the calipers like microns at a time, but I don't have a machine that's actually that accurate.
But then I thought, why don't I just use the thermal expansion of aluminum to move my calipers, but I need some kind of a reference to mount this to. So for that, I'm just going to use this steel bar, and the thermal expansion of the steel bar is half as much as the aluminum, so that should give me some movement across the whole length as the temperature changes. So I'm just going to firmly clamp these together on one end, and then on the other end, I'll put these here and clamp them to the steel bar. And then clamp the jaw to the aluminum bar.
And then I heated up this piece of square tubing real good and placed that underneath the metal bars and covered that with a cloth and left that running for a few hours.
I averaged together a minute's worth of samples at a time, typically about 188. Averaged those, converted to microns, and plotted that here. And the small divisions are microns, and it does seem to stay fairly consistently within a micron of itself. And the aluminum first expanded rapidly, then leveled off, and then slowly went back over the course of a few hours. Although looking at that curve for a few hours, at some point it got a bit noisy for some reason, and then here it jumped when I touched the apparatus the next day.
So overall, that looks pretty promising. Now, I wasn't actually sure if this topic would be really that interesting for a video, but I actually kept experimenting with this thing for 2 weeks now, because the experiments take a long time to run, and I found it interesting enough, so maybe you will too. And next I added some temperature sensors so I could actually plot my measured displacement against temperature. And then I wheeled the whole setup into my basement office because I heat that room up when I'm working in there, so it sees substantial temperature swings.
And I left the test setup running overnight as this room cooled down. And I also worked out the expected displacement over temperature. And plotting my overnight data, the purple line is the expected displacement based on one of the temperature readings, and the blue line is the actual displacement measured, so they do follow, but not super closely. But then I looked at the readings from the other temperature sensors, and they don't actually follow each other that closely either.
So my temperature was not that consistent, so I decided to cover it with a cloth so it would change more slowly and hopefully be more even.
And my next experiment was actually on a weekend, so I only heated this room up briefly, and my total temperature swing is only about 1.7 degrees, but the temperature sensors followed each other very closely. But then looking at measured displacement in blue versus displacement I expected based on temperature in red, and it doesn't follow that closely. Mind you, we're looking at a very small amount of change, like this is about 16 microns here, so that's like half a thou of total displacement on here. So as the temperature goes up, it does come up at the same time, but then the temperature starts dropping, and this stays up here until kind of we cross over a bit, and then it drags it down. And then as the temperature comes up, it's not enough to actually move the thing here. So it's as if I've got some kind of friction in the setup, and I need more expected displacement before it moves. So think of it as like there's this much slack here. Temperature comes up, drags it up. And then until we cross over by about this much, it doesn't really drag it down much. And then when we come up again, it doesn't go above it enough to actually move this because it's all within the slack or hysteresis caused by some kind of friction, I think. And I tried to reduce the friction by putting a little roller between the bars, but that didn't help any. So I think the friction and the deflection is all inside the calipers.
But at 3 microns, that's a pretty insignificant amount for calipers.
And another overnight run, only heated up a little bit on Sunday, and then on Monday I was working in here. Temperatures follow very closely, but looking at this, With a temperature swing of about 7 degrees, the scale is actually much larger, so being off by 3 microns with the hysteresis looks much less bad. And I fitted this together trying to figure out what scale that works best with my hysteresis theory. And again, we see temperature coming up. We see this flat until we cross over, and again, flat until we cross over, and again, kind of flat until we cross over. Now, I had to adjust that. My temperature prediction here is about 10% less than the formula would suggest, so something is different in terms of my experimental setup or possibly the temperature constants I looked up, but this seems to fit best based on my hysteresis theory. Now, it's also interesting, I've got a fairly straight up temperature rise here, but my displacement actually moves in sort of a bumpy fashion, and it seems to bump roughly every 10 microns or so. So I plotted just this part here, and here's my expected displacement, and here's my actual displacement. And if I hold a ruler to that, those bumps seem to be possibly about 2 microns in size.
So I've got some kind of nonlinearity, the size of about 2 microns, which again is not super significant because the calipers can only display 1/100 of a millimeter or 10 micron increments.
And if I take this graph and round it to the nearest multiple of 10 microns, because that's what the caliper can display, I get these stair steps like that, which at this point, these small deviations in here are completely invisible because we're talking such coarse units, 1/100 of a millimeter. And if I were to do it in inches and display it as a whole thousandths of an inch, the whole graph is like 2 increments, so it's really kind of invisible.
And just for scale, the thickness of a regular piece of paper on this graph would be about this much.
And I've been checking my various digital calipers against some stuff that I checked with a micrometer, and these ones are actually quite good. These ones are also very good. These ones not so good. Sometimes they're off by as much as 0.05 millimeters, so there's some linearity issues with the sensor in this one. And this one is downright terrible. And I bought these just hoping to tap into a digital interface on them, but these ones are the only ones I've got without a digital interface. They're just cheap plastic calipers, and they only display to 1/10 of a millimeter, but there's a bit of slack around here, so I can move this, what's on the display, by 0.2 millimeters easily, just by moving this part up and down, because there's so much slack. But again, these are really cheap ones. I just bought them for an experiment. But comparing to my dial calipers, I can trust these a lot more, because if there's something wrong with them, I could hear them or just feel that they don't work right. Unlike digital calipers, where it's all a matter of faith.
And the sensors inside digital calipers is just a circuit board with traces on it, measuring capacitive coupling against the circuit board in this part. And I'm pretty sure those could be made accurate to a micron. It's just for digital calipers like this, only going to 1/100 of a millimeter, there's no need to. But it also makes me realize there's a certain futility in measuring anything that accurate over any sort of distance. So watch this dial indicator when I touch an ice cube to this setup. Look at that move. That's 0.1 inch or 0.25 millimeter.